Okay, for this cell, I didn't have a complete piece with a tab of the screen and ordered more. I have some solid copper and we're going to paint the zirconium onto the copper surfaces. Zirconium silicate to raise the hydrogen over voltage. We don't want the copper screen bubbling hydrogen any more than we want the actual zinc bubbling hydrogen. So there it is, the current collector is copper, and I'm sure that the zinc will just plate onto it and everything will be connected just fine. And here's the zinc. Probably got it a bit thin here, all beading up. Now that's the back side. The front side we have to do the osmium layer on. Okay, the osmium doped acetaldehyde. It's probably not very visible here, but the heavy osmium powder has sunk to the bottom since I last used it. I'll just dip the brush down to the bottom anyway. It's doing a lot of beading up here. Recall that as being normal. Oh, now we're getting some of the zirconium mixing in. Okay, that restores our current because the sodium dodecylbenzene sulfonate on the separator sheet changes the way that the ions interact. And we need this to get the zinc to work again. Now we'll leave it at that. Now I'll put on some zinc powder. And then a bit more of this, and then some more zircon. So the zinc sheet was 13.75 grams of zinc. This is about 3.3 grams of zinc powder. My spoon here. Which we've used 1.3, leaving 2. So that's about 15 grams of zinc, which is like 12 amp hours theoretical. And let's see, are we going to try a bit more? We'll just leave it at that for the osmium and maybe add some more zirconium. Zircon. Now I've got zinc in my zircon. Well, I don't use the zircon for anything else, do I? Not sure this is the greatest way to do this, but this is how I'm doing it at the moment. Zircon is looking more and more like zinc. Okay, there's my zinky zircon. I'll wash that out. I think I'm done with it. Now we've got just a bit of splatter on the side here. Don't want any zinc to go through to the other electrode, that's for sure. Okay, we should be able to put the separator sheet on. Any separator sheet. Soaked twice with toluene and then painted with SDBS. And now we're going to run a bead of heat glue around the edge. What does this look like, zinc? We'll seal it all in so that the zinc can't escape from underneath. Okay, so a bead of heat glue around the edge. That I didn't have before, and I had the impression that the separator sheet might be leaking around the edge, so now the edge should be pretty well sealed up. Assuming I didn't miss anywhere. What else could you use but heat glue? It might be something, but I can't think of it at the moment.